So this will be the last to the very last session for the training course. And this is, section is for data visualization. Basically, there are three subsections. The first one will be give a very overall, briefly introduction to R, using R for visualized GTPP data. And the second subsection will be using ngBrowse. And the last one is using ODB. Okay. Now, so let's start with the first section. Okay. It's a data visualization in R. So there's a basic command in R called the plot. The plot, you just, there are two arrays, the X array and the Y array. So you want to plot X against Y, and the only thing to do is just the plot. This is a very high-level plotting. There's no fancy one. And you can, later on you can add, for example, the axis name of the axis or the Y-axis, and title and so forth. Okay. So points is a connection, each individual points. Put points on the chart, and the line is a connect each data point. Okay, and text. Just add plotting, add text to a plot at a given location. And legend, just put a legend to your current plot. Okay, now title, the same thing. You add title to your plot. And the axis, just plot axis, and so forth. The good thing for R, you can output your graphics into a different format. And right now, the most people using R, Bitmap, BMP, and JPEG is a JPEG format, or PNG is a PNG. So, and the tip, okay. To me, they are both are equally good, okay. And dev.off, just turn off the function. It's a function to turn off your device. That's mean, actually, that's mean you save your graphic to a single files, okay. So there's a bunch of ways to do this, and then maybe we can go ahead to step-by-step instruction how to do this. I'm going to do this from, since I'm on Macintosh, you can do it from your desktop by doing using bring the R window back. So I'm going to doing from here, but I have to talk to that machine, so over there. So, we will do, say, one by one, and you can follow me. So what I have to do from here, I just type to invoke R, and I type R into the Linux command line. And then what you do, you just click on the R icon on your desktop, and go to R environment. So you just say R, that's step number two, right? And bring the R environment. And I will try to define the ocean, I will, well, look, I'm going to assign the plot data within the Atlantic Ocean. So what I have to do is I say ocean. Ocean. Define ocean to be Atlantic, and I know I use ATL for Atlantic. Okay, now I like to define the boundary, so I say the northern boundary NLAT, the northern part of the ocean area which I'm interested in is 30 degree. Okay, and I can separate that. I can type in the next line, but I can use in the semicolon to separate. R stamens. So I type everything into on one single line. So the south latitude I'm interested in is 20 degree. It's south LAT, and I assign 20 for that number. Okay, and the same thing for western longitude, which I say in this case will be minus 98, and for the eastern longitude, I like to say 81 degree minus, which means the waist longitude. So it won't hurt to put another semicolon. But since this end of the this line, so I just go ahead to type press enter key. Okay, so right now I define my boundary, northern boundary, southern boundary, west and east boundaries. Okay, now I'm looking for year equal 2013. I define the spatial the dead range for say year equal to 2013, and the month will be the first month 01. Okay, if you don't use a single quote, that means month will be an integer. Since this time using month as a character, as a stream, so I had to close it by single quote. Okay. So now I say so this is another, I forgot what switch means, but anyway, this is right, and I will figure it out later. Okay, let's say I forgot, for example, I've been wrote this long time ago, I forgot what the switch means. I forgot this meaning of the switch. So I can always use an question mark and followed by the variable, I mean the function name, switch, because I'm looking for what's that switch mean? It's the TCH. So help, this is the way to get out the help. Always begin with question mark and then followed by the function name. So this is telling me why I use a switch. So switch means it's evaluate expression and accordingly choose one of the functions. So that's the way to get to recall yourself what that really mean. So I define code equal to, I know what that mean, because I like to say this time is for Atlantic Ocean. So this time you write source code, I can be easily to change from Atlantic to any ocean, any other ocean, say Indian or Pacific. Okay, so that's the reason why I'm using switch. Okay, so right now I say ocean, and there will be, in the future will be three options. The first one will be AT, which stands for Atlantic, and IND for Indian, IN for Indian, another shortcut, PAC equal to dot PA dot, okay. So this one. Now, it looks like okay, so we have to make connection. Let me see. This one doesn't write. Yeah, okay. We'll see. Okay. Here. And then make connection to using file. Equal to INV. I'm going to do a shortcut. Without typing. See, it won't help. It won't allow me to do that. Okay. It's not easy to work on this small screen. See. I think I'm going to give up because it's too much typing. Look at it. No, I'm going to quit. because the file is already on the material package. So I will go ahead and jump to the next. Okay. So this should be okay. The program even not there. Let me copy. I cannot find my source code in my training directory. It could be somewhere. Okay.
Charles, you need an O.
Yeah, I know that. I'm missing O. Okay, sorry, because I didn't copy to my own directory. Okay, let's just say I finish all the typing. Supposedly, this file should be entered as 9x9. Okay, so instead of doing that, I just go ahead to run from script from the command line. So I'm going to move this one into my G training directory in my personal account to G training. Okay, and I go to G training. And that's the R script. Actually, I should go to enter R. See. And that's it. To run the R script, it's just source. And then followed by the file name, which is gtppex12-1.r. Okay. Oh, that's another headache. This one need a inventory file, which is here. Okay, I'm not quite sure it's included in the data directory. Okay, but So I didn't upload that inventory file, but we can download from NODC webpage. Okay, so the inventory is 2013-01. Okay, now what I'm going to show you here actually is part of your presentation. In one of my requirements, I like you to locate the URL for the HTTP data structure, the URL site, and which was in one of my presentation PowerPoint. So this is gonna kind of tell you the answer before you give your presentation. So the data is only one data set, but you can access in a several ways, more than three. I think it's maybe three or four ways to do that. As Paul showed you yesterday. So there's an online distribution, right? So there's a full server, but it's always one data set. So the quick way to do it is either using HTTP / okay, data. This is the one way to do it. data.nodc.noaa.gov. Okay, and then follow up after that will be GTPP. Okay, so this is one way to download data. Okay, you can use wget from your Linux command line or using browser. This is the quick way to get GTPP data. So this is go overview what GTPP data infrastructure on the web. So when you go to that directory, data.nodc.nova.gov/gtpp, and this is the current structure it looks like. There's a directory called .o, and never use that because that directory .o is for backup only, just in case, because this website is updated daily, so we keep it old in just in case something didn't go right, so we will always be able to recover what left on yesterday. So you just forget about .o, and there's a readme file. So basically, readme file is the same as here. Okay, the readme file, and the Atlantic Ocean. So this is the data individual profile sorted by ocean. So Atlantic will be all the data within in the Atlantic Ocean, and it will be sorted by year. So we find out the oldest data is 1989. Okay, the oldest one. And so sorted by ocean and the year and the months. Okay, I'm sure this because I know there's not much data in that directory, so it's easier to show you the structure for the file. So this is every single individual file. Okay, so sorted by ocean. That year, look at that, it's plotted by ocean and year and month. So I can jump around, I'm going looking for Indian Ocean. So just change it to India. And let's say, looking for 1990. Okay, so you can move around. Once you know the structure, the path, or GTPP file, and you can go to 01, the first month. So we don't have that much data. We have some, but not really big. Okay, again, this individual nested file. Or you can go back, let's go back two, three level up. Okay, and then let me explain this to you. This continues to explain to you the structure of the data server. So the next one is called the best. Okay, and best is the monthly update, the monthly best copy for the data in main ASCII format, but compressed. So this is the AT, stands for Atlantic, and then 1990, the first month, January, and it's compressed, it's called GG. Okay, so this directory update on a monthly basis, as I said before, the 7th of each month, this entire directory will be updated. Okay, so the next one I'd like to tell you, the inventory file. So this is the inventory for each individual single file, and the file we are missing was AT something, right? It's called, where is my PowerPoint? It's AT 2013-01 and GTPP. So you look at Atlantic Ocean 2013. Yeah, okay. So there are two formats. The first one is just the plain text, it's uncompressed. And the second one is a zip, it's compressed. So let's just go ahead and download this one. I'm not quite sure I can download to that, to my server over there. Yeah, but this is, okay, I'm going to download it. So this is the way to save. But this was saved to my, to this Macintosh, not saved to my server. Okay. Yeah. So I continue to go through the structure here. And the next strategy called the best NC. Okay, which is the people will be most interested. This is the compressed NACD file in one single place. It's sorted by ocean, by year, and by month. So James just told me, because we try to load some kind of compressed file before the lunch break. And he kind of blamed me. I said, the file is on your server. So this is the way to download your file. Okay? So you can, right now, you can go ahead to download to your desktop, and later on we will give a demo to how to read compressed initially by ODB. Okay, so this is location. Okay, so. And you can look in all the file later on. It looks like this is a new machine, a new PC. So, and we test. Yeah, because I don't know, but I keep my finger crossed until I see it. Okay, supposed to be, but it looks like the same file which I try on my PC is slower. I hope this can be run faster. So you can pick out, you know, anyone you're interested in, and we will try later during, probably near the end of my presentation, you can see how fast all that machine will be. I knew that using the Linux is no problem. Even that PC is almost 6 years old. It's just really quick. Yeah, but I don't know how fast this new machine will be. Okay. So another thing I'd like to draw your attention is the real-time data. Okay, so all are delay mode except the real-time directory. The data in the real-time directory is a new. It's a near real-time. So this directory is updated. Depending on the format, the NACD file is only updated once a week, but the main ASCII is updated 3 times a week. Okay. So we are looking for individual NACD file, and it will be the same directory, 2014. This is for individual file in that month. So this is June, and you can look at the timestamp. It's June 2025, which is yesterday. Okay, and the kick out, this will got all the station within in the Atlantic Ocean in the June of 2014. So you can see the spinning is kind of relative, the number of the files is relatively large. Okay, you can see the spinning. Yeah. Okay, I'm going to stop here. I don't want to show that. Okay. So, however, I'd like to, you don't want to go to individual file. You can download this. And look at the time range, the stamp. Pick this as an example. This is a GTAPP format 4. The real-time NACD file is between 2014 March 16 to 2014 March 22nd. It's a one month range. One week range. So this is compressed. This is all the file during that week is compressed into one single file. Okay. Starting about maybe a couple weeks ago, we start distribute data in ODB spreadsheet format. So this is the last week. Okay, it's from June 15 to June 21st. So this is last week. It's always began from Sunday to Saturday. And this fast is available on every Wednesday. So we get roughly 2 or 3 days behind to cover the entire observation for that week, because there's a slight delay between Canada, or Canada got it, and finally at the end of this year, roughly in January is 1 to 3 days. So I gave them 3 days. So in that case, it will be enough time to cover all the real time observation for the previous week. Okay, so we can take a look at how this file looks like. This is the text file. Okay, so this is the GTAPP Ocean Data View spreadsheet format. So it's always begin with slash. It is a command line for ODB to understand. You just number in 999.990. That means the missing value. And this is the second line is just a header. Okay, I said the second line is header. The second line is the unit for each column. And so this begin with the cosine Q49.01109414. And they got the temperature. This is salinity, and the salinity flag is right here. Okay, and the temperature flag, and also depth flag. Depth is on top. Okay, so this is the spreadsheet looks like. And it's always empty on the first four columns, except the first line. So this is the ocean data view format. You can create your own, format according to this template, and it can be got to be this format. So in order to be readable by ocean data view, okay. So we will try during near the end of my presentation, okay. So the weekly spreadsheet is kind of relatively new, and this is the first time we make an official announcement. Okay. So you know the directory, right? Is data.nodc.nova.gov/realtime. So maybe you want to try during your exercise. See, can you read any one of the text file here, and by ODB? Okay. So I think I'm kind of going to change my presentation a little bit. I don't want to spend too much time on R right now, because I feel that the ODB is more attractive to everyone, in the room. So I'm going to say that's a difficulty to transfer the file between those two machines. So I'm going to just skip here for now, and maybe later on when I get the file ready, we can come back to visit the how to use R for display GTPP data. So I'm going to just stop here for now, and I can come back later on. So I will continue my presentation. So I will skip until my file is already ready. Okay, I'm going to talk about the Ocean NC Browse. That's another software, which available long time ago. Almost the first time we used is back to 1999, or even it's slightly 2 or 3 or 4 years before 1999. So NC Browse, it's a Java application that provides a flexible interactive graphic display of data in the NCDF convention. You can download, it's freeware, and it has a URL to download NC Browse. I have one. Okay, this is the NC Browse feature. It's expand flexibility in accordingly with user assignment of text. So you can change, because it's a Java, so you can change. You can change anything you like to see for the time axis and so forth. Okay, and it can run on Macintosh, Unix, Linux, or even on a PC hardware, because it's written in Java code. Okay, so I like about do me a favor, and did you see that the window, the NC Browse? Okay, let me walk over here.
So,
So look on the TV screen. I have a NC browser, PC version installed on my laptop. So the first thing you have to do, once you install, instructions very clear. It just take maybe a couple minutes to install. So you click on the NC browser icon and you bring out the NC browser main window. So you click on NC browser allow you to access data remotely, either from OpenDev or from WWeb or from LS. The problem for that kind of technique, you have to know very long path of your file. And most likely, no, I would not encourage people to use that one because it always didn't work quite right. So instead of open remote file, I will say open local file. So you keep out open file. Okay, and you will see, so you click on file, select on file, and it say open file. Okay, which already did on that window. Okay, and you will load one file into your NC browser. Right? You select data http something dot n. Okay, so from here, you can double click on temperature. Okay. Double click on temperature. On the right hand side panel, there's a click on double temperature. I know Bob is not a PC guy, so maybe I have to help him.
Yeah,
okay. So that will read the necessary file into NC browse. Now, if you didn't set out your time coordinate correctly, you will not be able to see the actual time display in this little box. This is only one single observation, so you always only have one value, the start. So this data is for 2012, January 15, 17:09, okay? And also show you the depth range is from 6 to 1926 meter, and they show you the length and long. So if you didn't construct your necessary file correctly, you will not be able to see all this information, okay? Okay. So next will be say, I like to do the graphic. Just click on the graphic, graph variable. You have to pick out Y, check Y, and reverse Y. Okay. Yes, and say next one will show you'll do the plotting. The plot and all the metadata information for temperature is appear on the screen correctly, including on the very small letter here, this is called temperature, and they tell you the longitude, latitude, and the time stamp, and the depth display correctly. Okay, this is not just display the level. For example, I don't know how many levels we have right now, but this display the actual depths. So you just say, because the interval for vertical is not equally spaced, okay, in most cases. So the GTPP data set is set up correctly, so you will be able to see the actual depth instead of just level. No, maybe let's say, for example, it's only 200 point, and sometimes you didn't set up your vertical axis correctly, so the vertical display will be distorted. It's not displayed correctly. Okay. So and then this one you can view as a tree. Okay, go to view. You can view as a tree. So view, tree view is a view or your necessity available. Or you can choose view by table view, but no. So there are a bunch of ways to do that. Okay, so this is the NC browse. Okay. Just a quick way to look at one single necessity file. Okay. So and I encourage you to try to, when you return to your institution, try to download NC Browse and just a way, a tool to get a quick look on each individual NC file. So next one, I'm going to move to Ocean Data View, which is most people are, I can tell there are a few people very familiar with Ocean Data View, but not everybody. Some of them are very familiar with Ocean Data View. What I try to tell you, there are a lot of features in Ocean Data View is not well addressed in the Ocean Data View menu guide, particularly for GTPP data. In the GTPP data user guide, which already included in the course package, right now it's still in draft, called version 2, we have one section dedicated for Ocean Data View to tell user, to tell GTPP user how to use Ocean Data View to display GTPP data. Okay, so right now I kind of walk with you, see how we install Ocean Data View. So Ocean Data View is a software package that can easy access, or you can do it interactively, visualize your not just profile, but also time series or trajectory, or almost all kind of data. And the ODB is available at this website. Okay. Now, the feature with ODB, ODB is available Windows, Macintosh, Linux, and Unix. Okay. It supports native ODB collection. So that means you can read a different source and combine together into one single collection saved in ODB format. So that means next time you want to do the data analysis, you can read more quicker, faster. Okay. So it's read and import all major oceanographic data format, including ARGO, GTPP, WOD, and SIS DataNet 2, SD2. And display data in various plot type, which all allow the interactive data analysis and the visualization. Okay, now setting up Ocean Data View, how to do that? The first step, you have to download. Okay, I was told the ODB is not installed on your current machine because this is the new machine and we are very, very lucky to use the new machine. So I believe there are only two or three people from Indonesia, Malaysia, and Jim, you are able to bring up ODB, you install, right? But not the trend. Did you install ODB yet on your machine? You did, okay, good. How about you? Not yet. Okay, so this will be part of exercise number one, to download ODV. Okay. Is that right? Yeah, that's what I said. You have to download and install as part of exercise. Yeah, so Paula, your machine has not installed yet. So this is the URL, but you have to register. Oh, okay. Any way to find out?
Yeah, I can go
from there. Okay. Do you want to do it?
No, you go to the share.
You don't have to register to download?
No, we already shared them for download. Just watch it over file. You can just double click and then
copy. And after you install it, you don't need your username.
No.
Actually, when you download, you save on your local drive, right? Can you move to share drive?
Yeah,
you did it? Okay, so you can copy from share drive. Okay.
Mine is already installed.
You already have it installed.
Almost installed.
So next step. It is to install. Okay, you register and then you install. It's almost finished. So everybody know that download ODB, and this is the place to download. Okay, install ODB, which is, should be very easy. Installing on a Linux machine is a little bit work, but no, it should be okay. And I will skip this one because we are only focused on the PC version only for now. Okay, now getting started. Okay, you download ODV4, Okay, right now I'm going to tell you how to import GTAPP compressed density file into ODB. Okay, now this will be a good time to challenge that new machine. So you open up ODB. Before we open up ODB, let's return to my previous talk to download one of the GTAPP file. Okay, let's try the real-time. No, it doesn't matter because real-time is compressed as well. Okay, so why would you try real-time? Okay, let's go back to real-time. Okay, using your browser and go to this web page data.nodc.nova.gov.gtpp.nl/real-time. Okay, and pick out the one which was for last week. It's this one, June 25th, this one. Okay, did that block your view? Okay, see that? Yeah. And it's save into your local G-training data directory. Okay, are we done here so far? Are we? Where we are downloading, I'm trying to give you a demo, see how the Linux system works for ODB. So in the Linux system, okay, I had to type ODB4. Do you remember that on day one, I asked everyone to add a path to enter the .bassrc file. So that's location for the ODB. That's location I installed the ODB. So the way to invoke ODB, I had to say ODB4. So right now I say ODB4, we'll bring ODB onto. So right now I'm talking to the server over there. Okay. Now you can try it later on. I'm going to try to import TGG file. Okay, so the step is to say, click on import. Don't do it right now because we are waiting your transfer to finish. Okay, and I will let you do it later on. So the way to import the NCDF tar file is you click on import and select US NODC format and select GTAPP. Okay, and they were looking for .tgg file. You can see from this window. So they are zipped GTAPP 3.8 and or 4.0. Okay, either it was a TGG lowercase or TGG uppercase or zip or uppercase zip file. So I know where I installed. So it got to be, actually it's in my home directory. No. Here, okay. I'm going to use a different data set, which is someone blame me. It's on your PC, on your server. I'm going to just show on Indian Ocean, okay, for last month. So I click on this one and I say open. Okay, and they were asking me to give a new name for this collection. Okay, so I can rename it, but right now I can rename it to say just say GTAPP, anyway, I like to name it GTAPP, say IND, the Indian Ocean, okay, because this is for Indian Ocean. And I say save. So that will start reading compressed file about, I say 30 or something megabyte compressed. You see that really fast. It takes a couple, you can see the bars moving. Okay, and it's done. So it's less than 30 seconds. the file size is you encompress about 40 or 30 megabyte. Okay, and they'll ask you to, do you want to compress? And you say okay. And we'll change the color from red to blue, the dot. Okay, so it's done. So it's already loaded into ODB. Okay, so I will walk over to see if all the file transfer is complete. Is that right? It's quick? Oh, that's right. So far we know how to download, install, and download GTP data, right? And load it into ODB in the TGG file format. Okay. So next one, I'm using a different area. I'm using the Indian Ocean only, but should be the same. You guys got the whole world for last week. So next step, we like to do some kind of graphic. Okay, now let me try to return to my PowerPoint. Okay, so we done this so far, and we got this one, right? Import. So next one, I like you just follow. Okay, so we import initially, we select the TGG file, okay? Now, so we are okay so far. So next time, so we got load, and they were asking you, say, do you want to convert it into ODB native format? And you say, yes, I'd like to do that. So you got, will change from, the color will change from red to blue. Okay, and you say yes, and so forth, and say blue. So this is where we are right now. Okay, this is look at the entire ocean, as you have right now. Okay, so next step, we would like to visualize the individual profile. Okay, so and just the, what I say here, look into what you have, what have been loaded into the your ODB. So click on collection and browse inventory. Okay, this may be take a while because the file size may be too big. So go ahead to click on collection, then select browse inventory to display the content of the GTP native data set. Okay, so go ahead to click content, click collection. You did it? Everybody did it? Okay, that's good. So you see very similar to what I show on the screen, right? Okay, now so you can close that window. Okay, so now ODB has four or five way to display data, and when I show you it's called scatter plot. So by doing this, let me return to my screen here. So you can do the same thing as I'm telling you. Okay. So go back to view menu. So click on view and select layout template. And select two scatter windows. Okay. Anybody, but don't click yet. Just go to view, select view first, and I say layout template, and select two scatter. You see, they have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the five way to display data. Okay, but we are interested in scatter diagram, scatter window for now. So once you see the scatter diagram, the two scatter diagram, click on that one. Okay, and you should see something very similar to mine, right? So this is a display everything into two separate windows. The window to my right is a temperature verse. Let's see, is it too big? There are three windows on my left hand side panel. The first one is the salinity in the x-axis, and the y-axis is the depth. And there's another window on the right-hand side. It's the temperature versus depth as a vertical axis. And you see there's a red line. This is the current position. Look like this is it. So you can change No, you can change to any location you feel you like to see. Okay. And the line on each window will change accordingly what you see. On the right hand side, there's another menu. Okay. This is called the station ID. Station ID actually is the sequence number of the file being loaded. It's not TCP/IP definition of station ID. It's totally TCP/IP station ID is in TCP/IP database. So OTV doesn't use that information. Doesn't import the station ID. Okay, the station ID here is the sequence number of data being loaded. Look like this will be the 2825th profile. Okay. And this is the end. I'm even not even know the accession number. This is different than what NODC means accession number. Okay, this is a really definition about accession number in the ODB. I believe, I hope so, but I'm not sure. But cruise ID, cruise is fine. This is a cruise ID. This is TTPP cruise ID. Here we are. This is TTPP station ID. Okay, on the third row of the right hand side menu, this is the TTAPP station ID, and this is the position. And this is 52 degrees east and 35 degrees south, and this observation date, time, and the depth range is from 6 meter to 1829 meter, and this is the data type, TTSEC message. So it's because this is a real time, so you should see either TSEC or basic, okay, and if there is a dilemma, they will show you is a CTD or whatever, and below that, this is sample. Right now, in this particular case, look like there are 68 observations in the vertical, so you can use your arrow key and keypad, and you use it up and down, and the red dot will be moved down. Once it moved down, it will change. So once you change, the number on the right-hand side change as well. So this is change, and right now the depth is 149 meter, and the temperature is 15.53 centigrade, and the salinity is 35.445 PSU. Okay, so you can use the arrow key to move the current position, or in this chart, so you can move to next station. You want to move to the right, you're using the arrow key to the right, the right arrow key, and you can move to the right, or you can move to the left. Actually, this is not quite right. This is move according to the order has been written into the ODV. Okay, so this is one way to display ODV in which he called the scatter diagram. Okay, so next time, this one, I will show you another task, which one out of your presentation is to display TS diagram, temperature versus. I can see James can open his eye because he already did it. Okay, I'm going to tell you how to do the TS diagram. Okay. This is maybe a little bit challenging because there's so many files here. Okay, the way to do it is what I did. Okay, click on view. We're going to change the layout from two scatter diagram into one scatter diagram. Yeah, okay. So change from two to one. Okay, I never tried this before, but we will see. Okay, So this time, plot everything into one single window. Okay, and because this screen is too small, this is a plot temperature versus depth. The TS diagram is the temperature versus the salinity. So we have to change the x-axis and the y-axis. Okay, by changing that, using the right button of your mouse, click on window, on the area. Okay, and they say I'm going to change x variable. Right now it is temperature, but I have to display salinity. I like to say the vertical y is x is temperature, and the horizontal should be salinity. So I change from temperature to salinity. Click on the x-axis and pick up salinity, and you say okay. But I like to see the vertical coordinate got to be temperature. So I change the y variable from depth to temperature. Okay. So this is the way we, you know, look like it is kind of lumped together because this is so many data files. So it looks like it. And so this is the TS diagram. Okay. But without depth information missing. So to add depth information to this chart, you have to select the G variable. So by doing that, you click on your right mouse, right button on your mouse, and select the G variable to depth. And you say, okay. So this looks much nicer. So this gave you information, not just the temperature and the salinity relationship, but also telling you the depths. So it looks like this is kind of a one watercolor mess. This the purple one looks like near the surface. So that means in the Indian Ocean, in general, no, surface will be somewhere between, temperature will be somewhere 31, 32, and the salinity will be somewhere between look like 15 to 30, you know, PSU. Okay, so you can move your cursor to different location, and actually on the left hand side, there's a window. There's another window showing the location or your data point. So this is too many file within a single small window, so you don't see the information about the location. But at least this is demonstrate you. Even with the older machine, it's about 6 years old, and it was a really small memory, only 2 gigabytes. And I think this is the speed can be beat what you have right now. I think this machine is this year or maybe last month, I don't know. But definitely, this is the kind of demonstrate to you that the Linux can do a much, much better job than Windows. Okay, even with a really old machine, it's relatively faster. Okay, and there are also a lot of capability on Linux machine. So that's the reason why I'm kind of pushing, you know, you most people using switch from Windows, at least from Windows to Linux, not from Macintosh. Macintosh is okay. Because once in my Macintosh, you actually buy two systems in one place. The Linux, like, is also the Macintosh Linux. So that's good, but it costs more money. You know, it costs more, almost five times, you know, four times. No.
Not anymore. No, actually, the comparable systems are getting close to the same price.
I don't believe that. Because I know, when I look at Apple.com, I spent maybe 12 entry to buy, to do the same thing I like to do for my Linux.
You get what you pay for.
Yeah, because the hard card, the material. I can drop, but I cannot drop my data. Yeah. Okay. So this is the way to display the TS diagram, okay? So I will walk everybody's window to see you. Anyone arrive the same, have the same figure, okay?
Okay, so right now
it's looking like we are pretty okay with the, at least we can read the TGG file into ODB. So the next task, okay, I'm not going to do it from here. I will ask you to do this, but I will tell you what to do. We're going to, yes. We're going to do the same thing for the spreadsheet format. Okay. So, okay, before I ask you to download the spreadsheet format, I'm going to demonstrate to you first, and you download and do your on your own. Okay. So I had to quit this one because I don't want to mess up. Okay, I'm going to start from beginning. Okay. So I like to load a spreadsheet format, the ODBC spreadsheet format, the GTAPP spreadsheet format. I like to make sure that I have that data file available. Okay, I have one available. So I'm going to use to demonstrate to you how to read spreadsheet format, the GTAPP spreadsheet format. And you the people in this room, probably the first group to use the GTAPP spreadsheet format. Okay. ODB, again, I'm ODB from a terminal. Okay, I'm going to load. Okay, now you just listen to me what I demonstrate to you. Once I finish, I will not repeat again, and you will do this. No. Okay, so to load the spreadsheet format, it's already on my local machine over there. There are two ways to do it. The first way is to import ODB format, ODB spreadsheet format from the import menu. Okay, that's one way to do it. Okay, import. Okay, I'm not going to import right now. Another way is to use a file, and it's open, and looking for your text file, the spreadsheet file. So basically, just different way, and come to the same location. So either way should be fine, should be okay. So let's just try using the import ODB spreadsheet, which I know the location for this one. Is under my training and under is okay. Make this one. This file is when we make a noise and people next door complain. This is the delay mode data returned to NODC from Canada. So you can see there's a lot of collection in the near the what is the area? The
St. Lawrence.
Yeah, okay. So because I already tried on that machine, so it looked like it already done because it was the second time you load the same file, and ODB will take you to where you left. Okay. So I'm going to delete already in my directory. Okay, and I'll give you a fresh look for this. Okay, so I'm going to. So I know this is the directory. Once you run your ODB, and this is the directory they will create, ODB will create for you. Okay, not this one. Let me see which one. This one. Okay, this is an ODB file naming convention. Okay, always start from your own file name and end up with something that data. So I have to delete this directory. I have to delete that rf remove. Force to remove and also the directory below. Okay. And GTAPP. CMDM delay mode. CD GTD data from in 2012. Data. Okay. So this will remove all the ODB collection for that data type. So I will return back to ODB. For. Okay, again, I'm going to import the spreadsheet, right? So this time should be start from scratch. And I say here, and looking for something that ended with .txt, the text extension. I'm looking for this one. This is converted from main ASCII to Ocean Data View format. Okay. And I say the same thing, I say yes. Okay, and this should. It start loading. It's done. Okay. Next. Okay. Now I like to show you how to zoom to this area because this is the global map, the whole map. So for doing that, use I say you can do just here in the room. And there was a window, there was a red box come out. And no, okay, let me try to open up. No, because it allows me to. There's a red box surrounding the global map. So you can make the window fit to the area of your interest. Okay, and you can resize this map. You can zoom in a little bit. You can zoom in. And after that, you just press enter. And you can keep going. You can keep zoom a little bit and make it even smaller. Even look in a more detailed area. Yeah. Okay. So this is the way to load ODB spaceship format. And from here we can do the same thing as we did for the entire the weekly NetCD file. Okay, it's a view. Normally I will pick out the two scattered windows. Okay, so that's where we are right now, right? And you can view a different way. You can say view one scattered diagram. View temperature layout template to one scatter diagram. We'll put and change the axis to temperature and salinity. Okay, the x variable to salinity and the y to temperature and also add g variable to depths. Okay. So this is the way to load a spatial format into ODB. Okay. Now, what happens if I like to see individual file only, just one single NetCD file? I like to take a quick look on that one because this is a lump everything together. I like to see one single NetCD file. So the way to do that, okay, let me see. We cover this one. We over cover this one too, right? So okay, this is where I'm going to tell you. Okay. Import a local or remote GTAPP NetCD file format into ODB. Let's just say I like to take a quick look on one single file. Okay, now again, this is very similar to NC Browse. It can allow you to open remote file, but the question or the issue is you have to recognize the very details, the URL for each individual file. And so that doesn't make any sense to me. So instead of open remote, I will open the local file, or open NetCD file. Okay. So in the ODB bar, you pick an ODB and click on file open. Okay, I'd like to give you a real demo on this one. Again, I'm going to close this exit. Okay, and return back to ODB again. Okay, before I do that, I'd like to make sure that we don't have that collection in the ODB. Okay. Dash F. I like it to this guy. Okay. So I like to load one single NetCD file in the local directory. So what I have to do is click on file and click on open. Okay, because this is a local file. And you are looking for something and with NC. See that? NC. So I back each, this is one single individual NetCD file. And we say open. Okay, so it's quite different. So again, this message is not quite well addressed in the ODB menu. Okay, so particularly for GDPP. So the first thing to do, you have to define the NetCDF dimension. Okay, because each different NetCDF format has slightly different dimension. So we have to pick out time, G in the vertical, Y latitude, and the X longitude. So you have to select all the first four. Okay, so define the dimension and then click on list. Okay, and this is all available. We want to display all of them, so we don't want to make any change on this one. Okay, now click on next. Okay, now this got to be careful. This is called available dimension, and asking for select primary variable. You have to select depths. Okay, you have to select depths on the second row on the left hand side menu. Select depths. Okay, now read in. So you see the blue dot here, because this is somewhere in the ocean. You don't see the ocean coastline, because it's somewhere in the middle of the ocean. So you say okay, finish. So it's read. Okay. And in the by default, this is what trend run into a problem. Say, where's my file? It's already there, but I didn't see anything. So and actually this is the first time when I see this, I said this is very confused to me. Say enter to add value. I really don't know what, so I try so many things. And when I realize this actually doesn't mean anything. So you just say click enter and it will load into your Windows. So that this is default ODB window. So how many windows is it? One total six window beside your geographical map. So this is default ODB layout. So there are so many windows here that can sometimes it's a little bit too much. So I would like to return to a previous way to view ocean profile. So I like to change from this much window into only, let's say, two scatter windows. Okay. A layout template is two scatter windows. Okay, and then by default, this is by default. So you always can change the X and Y variable to display the way you like to see. So I like change this one to just say temperature, seawater temperature. Because the word in here, seawater temperature, is the NetCDF variable name. Okay, this is called standard name, seawater temperature. Okay, in the vertical, it's already dead, so that's fine. But in the meantime, I like to see the quality flag of this file in a separate window. So it's already there. Okay, so this window show you the flag or temperature versus the depths. Okay, and it looks like it's all one. See that all one. So it's look this flag as good data. Okay, and I know this is a TSEC message by looking at the data tab on the right hand side. Oh, not there. Yeah, because I see there's this particular profile has a temperature and a salinity, so I should be able to display TS diagram. So, and then we can go over again. Say, I'd like to see the TS diagram. So, to do that, you select the view. And then go to layout template and pick out one scatter diagram. Yeah, okay. Now again, this is our third time to see the TS diagram. So you change Y variable to salinity, okay, and change the V vertical variable to temperature, to C or C temperature. Okay, and you can add the depths to your chart. Okay, this is the first one. Okay, so this is show you not just TS diagram, but to also show you the location for each single the depths for each measurement. And look, this is in the near sea surface. It look like this. Only I'm sorry, this is near the sea bottom. This is roughly between I said 15,000 to 2,000 meter depths. And I hope this is look like a purple, and here it look like a near surface. Okay, so and you can save these figures, save canvas as so that you will save to your local hard drive. Okay, and you can save in different format, the GIF or JPEG or TIF or even Postscript. Okay. So far, any question for me? So this is my intention. We are not going to tell you how to do the data analysis on ODB, because that will be a different course. That will be, IoT has a different course for user to learn how to use ODB. So my purpose is just telling you how to load GTAPP data in a three different format, right? So we've got compressed table in HDF. Also, the second one is the spreadsheet format. And the very last one is the individual HDF file. So this is my purpose, to tell you how to load into ODB. And later on, you can play with the tool. This tool allow you to do so many funny, very, very good things. You can do the data analysis or whatever, like origin calculator, and so forth. Okay, so any questions so far? Yes. You can add. Is that you mean? Oh yeah, okay. I know what you're talking. That's called the GWI. Okay, the file you download is a made ASCII. It's compressed. You can select compressed or not compressed. So you need one more steps. You need to convert from made ASCII, which is GTAPP ASCII file, into GTAPP ODB spreadsheet. Okay, yeah. Which I can lack of the resource to provide more tool onto that web page. So supposedly it should allow you to select a different format, for example, compressed HDF or even a spreadsheet format. But right now, the GWI is only allow you to download the ASCII file. So that's one more step you have to do on your own. They convert to a made ASCII to spreadsheet. Okay, and we have another tool allow you to convert into HDF. Yeah, but that's, you don't have to do that. Yeah. Okay. So this is will be your part of your presentation, and I hope you should have any difficulty to get presentation. So you may want to try to download, which we did on Monday. You create the area of your interest. You may want to try to convert that file into ASCII by one or two, which already is an R. I said using R, convert to a spreadsheet. So the program to do that is called GTAPP to ODB. But if you have to edit that file, which I probably can work with you, later on. Okay. So I still have a couple of slides to show you to finish my presentation here. So okay, so we finish this. We know how to open a single HDF file. Okay, I like to finish this one. Okay, so I like to give a summary about the additional ODB features. Okay, so there are four basic plots, or sometimes we call windows. The first one is the station plot. The second one is the scatter plot, and also section. This means you can do cross section. And the fourth one is a service plot, okay. So this is the staging plus looks like. This is a default. No, you didn't do anything. Most likely, you will see this plot. Okay, and we saw this a couple of times. Scattered plus, and the second one will be section, a cross section. You can try it, you know, later on. And the very last one is to do a surface. I like to see, look at the surface, and this is really cool, really nice in the feature. Okay, and this I can repeat the staging plot, the scatter plot, you know, and so forth. So it's a really nice, handy tool. Even you can do quality control. Okay, look like there's a figure, the data point is really off. Everything is here, but this is kind of a problem with this quality. Okay. And you can narrow down to you can squeeze into make a smaller window and look into that one particular section. Okay, this is the subset. This is on the left hand side is the full sample set, on the right hand side is the sample subset. Okay, so not really yet.